Hey traders, this is Tosh. I go by TBradley90 in the My Investing Club chat. A general reminder for those who do not know, MIC is having a one-year anniversary event where Bao is going to be trading live in front of our members. It's coming up August 17th. Mark your calendars. As an added benefit for our members, the event is 100% and exclusively free for annual and lifetime members, while lifetime, on top of that, get extra coaching before the event and guaranteed front row seating. While most charge for these events, we show our support by making it, again, free for annual and lifetime members. If you are interested in signing up for this event, DM TBradley90 in MIC Slack chat and or email myself at tosh@myinvestingclub.com. Now, we have a very special video for you guys this week as Aloha Trader, who is Austin, real name in MIC chat, does a trade recap this week on ticker symbol CETX, and he talks about reactive trades. And while this is just a preview of the full-length video, if you want to watch the full-length or any of our exclusive content, then become an MIC member.
Hey everybody, Austin here. Gonna do another trade recap. I'm doing it in the middle of the night, so that's why the light's on. I'm sorry if there's a glare. But before I do, I want to say I'm not licensed or registered. I'm not a financial advisor, and none of this should be taken as investment advice, even if it sounds like it. Okay, so yeah, I had a few trades last week, and I like, the reason why I'm doing this, I guess, a little late is because I couldn't really decide which one to do it on. So I remember in my Thursday webinar, I asked, like, which one you guys would like to see a recap on, and, you know, like, people shout out CETX, XSPA, or ATOS, something that they want to go more in depth. Some people said all of them. I'm like, well, maybe I can kind of go over through all of them, but like talk about the specs that really make them, the details that make them alike and whatever. But anyway, I want to go over CETX. That's what most people said they wanted me to go over. So, like, I was putting dips here as this went on in the morning, and it just didn't dip. It just kind of went parabolic up, and I said, okay, whatever, fine. You know, like, I missed this, and then I was like, oh, let me catch the dip. You know, it just kept soaring. I'm like, fine. You know, I wasn't going to chase, right? I was waiting for the dip. But anyway, so I missed that, but I kept watching it throughout the day, and one of my favorite setups kind of came up. And it's where we get, it's kind of where we get this, like, this hard pullback that says, hey, this might be the top. This is the first hard pullback that says this might be the top over here. And we start to downtrend and make a couple of lower highs, and then we get this mean slam down kind of in the middle of the day where it might think that everyone might think it's done, right? And so this is kind of the short trap here, you know, the hard pull, the lower high, and the breakdown here. A key thing to note, though, is that, like, where it initially broke out from 350, it's still holding, right? Like, this consolidation is still a support. So it's not like a death line crack, where a death line crack is like when the whole, no support is left. You know, we broke out here from 350, that's still there. These are dips, you know, like $3 consolidation, you know, you could probably consider that the death line, right? $3.04. Like the last support, basically. This was not it, right? A lot of people want to try to anticipate the, like, a higher death line so they can get a better average, and they can. They just have to know that, like, the move might not be over until the last support is broken.
Hey traders, this is Tosh. I go by TBradley90 in the My Investing Club chat. Just wanted to reach out and say, if you have any questions about MIC, joining MIC, maybe you're a member already, you have three ways to contact myself personally and through MIC. You can hit our social media, you can hit me through PMs in chat, or you can contact us through my email at tosh@myinvestingclub.com. That's TOSH@myinvestingclub.com. I will get back to you in a timely manner, and I'm saying this because I'm here to help, and I don't want anybody to be afraid to reach out and ask any question that they have. We are here for you guys. All right, see you guys.